All right, guys, from the over and under again, let's try to work the head and arm control and go for another choke. This choke, guys, I call Cake of Bones, you know? It's a funny name, but I created that name because it's a variation of the Peruvian necktie, okay? The Peruvian necktie is a really good technique to do from there. However, my arms are really short, you know? Sometimes I have a little bit of problems with locking this properly. And the way that they set up, some people set up in different ways. I'm gonna show you my perspective of that, and everything is based on that grip right here, okay? It's gonna be the 10 finger grip. There's a lot of knuckles and fingers of the hand and things like that. That's why I call it Cake of Bones. There's a lot of bones involved on that, okay? So I'm gonna do the same thing for an over and under. Move my hip, boom, lock the arm. I go with the hand over there, a control, okay? So I'm gonna do the steps back. One, two, put his head on the floor right here. So controlling there, I switch to the gable grip, I duck his arm. I duck his triceps in. I'm gonna be moving here, one, and I'm gonna be controlling. Okay, situation here. Number one, my abs are too short. To lock it properly here to the anaconda choke is hard. To go for the darce is also hard. Okay, so what I'm gonna do here is that I'm not gonna be worried too much about digging my arm too much. Okay, I'm just gonna move and enter my knee on that space and be completely perpendicular to him. So you notice that I still have the control, okay? My knee is helping me out also in order to put his arm dominated, but I have problems with my grip now. I cannot finish in any of those because my arm doesn't dig in completely. So, that's the secret right here. From there, switch your grip to this one. So you see that I'm gonna have 10 fingers together and that bones here will be really exposed, the knuckles right there, okay? And I'm gonna align the knuckles right here underneath his chin. So I have the knee in, I align, boom, underneath the chin here on the neck, okay? I step this leg up. Now I'm just gonna go down a little bit. How am I gonna go down? I'm gonna go down making him the false sensation that he can come on top of me. So I step the other leg up over his leg, his head, and the other goes over here, his body. So you see that he gets trapped on there, and my cake of bones, my hands, my 10 finger hand grip is right there on his neck. When I put my head down in my hip, almost like in the levers, they're gonna be similar to the arm bar, and I bring the cake of bones towards my body, guess what happens? Get a really super tight choke and he taps.